Hello, everyone. I'm here with Dave Schumann of Cloudera. Welcome, Dave.
Lucien, thank you so much.
Thank you. And we're talking about smart cities. So first, let's define what exactly is a smart city.
So we tend to think about smart cities as technology. We're always focused in on the sensors and the sensorization that we can have within these environments. But I think we have to take a step back and say a smart city is about how we can create public policy to create an environment that citizens want to live in, that is safe, that is equitable, and that it supports a quality of life where our citizens want to be. And that's all about being smart.
Thank you for that. Now, let's talk a little bit about some of the trends. You talk to customers every day. You've mentioned earlier you've got about 85 countries covered.
Yeah.
I've also seen a recent report from Future Cities that talk about some cities that are lacking behind. Perhaps give us some trends and give us some regions that may be more advanced than others.
Well, one thing I think you have to think about with cities is this is not an instantaneous effort. Cities take a long plan about how they're going to support their citizens, but they have to do that in a safe, fair, equitable manner. So often they will look at plans and look at programs that help to drive those kinds of outcomes. You have more controlled and planned cities, and I look at Singapore as a great example of that, where the government has a great deal of control over the policies, and they're able to rapidly move across transportation, across utilities, across housing, across immigration, across law enforcement in sort of a cohesive manner. In some of our more open democracies, you have to be able to work that policy with your citizens. And so I look at the city of Portland, for example, that focuses in on how they're going to create more safe environments for their citizens, better streets, safer water. But they're doing those in very careful, incremental steps rather than these sort of sweeping changes. So you'll see that kind of two different speeds as we go about it. But I wouldn't characterize that as one city not making progress in comparison to the others. Each one of them is moving at the pace that meets their policies and the governance that they have with their citizens.
Thank you for that. I just returned from Copenhagen actually a couple of weeks ago, and you can see the efforts is a citizen one as well, not just the government policy and so on. Cloudera, give us a sense as to maybe some of the use cases, one or two, that may inspire other cities to take an action at their own pace.
Well, let's go back and let's talk about the design patterns. And there are two critical design patterns we see in smart cities. One is how can we centralize the data that we have that's available to us to be able to use all of the data that the municipality has. So it's a centralization of data play where you're looking at, you know, things like from voter registration, from licenses, from permits, being able to use some of the more real-time data that's coming in from sources in social media and from some of the mapping and engagement softwares like Waze or Facebook or Twitter. Looking at how we can incorporate policy-oriented data, like where do we have permits that are being put in, and some of the telemetry data. That's sort of a centralization viewpoint that cities are taking. The other viewpoint is how do I sensorize something that has not been sensorized today? How do I put in smart lights, which has been one of the big initiatives we see going on with cities, and use that to lower our power bill, to use the right amount of radiance that we need for the environmental conditions. But then also in that same infrastructure, I can put things like microphones and cameras and sensors and start to incorporate that in the data fabric of the city. So our two patterns end up being, on one side, centralization of data, and the other side is how can I use edge architectures to be able to add new areas of instrumentation for the city. Now to your other question, which is where do we see cities actually acting on that today? And you have key programs that are going on. Transportation is one. It's the source of 29% of all of the carbon emissions that we have on the planet. We are focusing on initiatives that are going to reduce our carbon footprint. So we need to understand transportation. We need to improve that experience, whether it's reducing the time that people are driving around looking for parking, whether it's reducing the amount of time that we spend in traffic, whether it's reducing the amount of time that we spend with vehicles moving unproductively, that they're not on mission at that point. And so transportation tends to be one of those key areas we focus on. But equally, we could focus and say we're doing this around safety with water quality, or we're looking for improvements in our utilities. We're looking for leakage within our water systems or other types of leakage that are occurring within our electricity system. So these are areas where cities tend to focus on where they can have the most impact with data up front.
Got it. So you've mentioned Edge, yet your name of the company is Cloudera. So help us understand, what are your solutions? Is it on the edge? Is it in cloud? Is it a hybrid solution? What exactly do you offer for the cities?
Yeah. So when Cloudera was founded, we had a vision of being able to use all of the compute environments that we had available to us. And the larger of those environments was going to be within our concept within these public clouds. Where the world is evolving now is that compute is everywhere. Compute is at the edge, compute is in our data centers, compute is in private cloud architectures, and compute is in the public cloud. Cloudera wants our customers, our citizens, our governments to be able to take advantage of all that compute. And so with our product, the Cloudera Data Platform, we are enabling our customers to use any of those environments to provide productive use cases on data. So to be able to do machine learning, whether that's at the edge or in the data center, to be able to build out integration so that I can have a faster experience renewing my driver's license, or I can have a better prediction on what my taxes are going to be. All that's going to use a ubiquitous compute environment. So you see this distributed compute, we want to take advantage of that wherever that is. And the Cloudera Data Platform does just that.
Thank you for that, and stay tuned as we follow the progress on cities of the future.